so I harness the breeze. You're welcome to fill your sails and shake your trees. So what can I say except you're welcome?
Firstly, attach the jib tack to the bow. On this National 12, the jib tack attaches to the bow fitting with a pin and a split ring. However, some National 12s may use a shackle. Making sure the sail is unfurled and a jib wire is not twisted, connect the head of the jib to the jib halyard with a shackle. The other end of the jib halyard will appear out of the rear of the mast. Ensuring there is nothing for the jib to get caught on, pull the halyard to raise the sail. On this National 12, where the halyard changes from the rope to the wire, there is a loop. Connect the jib hook to the loop, but firstly, make sure the shrouds are slack and the mast ram and lowers, if you have them, are off too. Once the loop is attached, pull the jib and rig tension on. We have a white mark on the mast, where we know our base setting is for the jib halyard. I will then pull on each shroud to the same tension. We have our shroud ropes marked with coloured blocks, spaced out every inch along the rope near the centreboard case. Next, we hoist the mainsail. Firstly, ensure the main halyard is running straight down the back of the mast so it is not caught in the spreaders, around the jib halyard or around the front of the mast. Then, unroll the mainsail to find the head and attach the halyard. We create a loop through the head of the mainsail for the bobble on the end of the halyard to go through, then pull the loop tight. Next, ensure the boat is head to wind and pull the main up using the halyard, ensuring the rope is running outside the cleats on the mast. It often helps if your crew is able to feed the mainsail into the track on the back of the mast, especially if there is some breeze in the dinghy park. Once the mainsail is within the black or white bands, keep the tension in the halyard and lock it into the cleats on the mast. With the mainsail hoisted, you now need to attach the Cunningham or downhaul. On our boat, this runs through the block on the mainsail and then onto the gooseneck in a loop. Unfortunately, I forgot to attach this whilst filming this video. With the boom on the gooseneck, I then attach the clue of the mainsail to the boom. Firstly, I attach the outhaul, which comes out of the back of the boom, through the clue eye, and then return the rope to the back of the boom. If the boom will not lift up to the clue, ensure the kicker is free and not caught on anything inside the boat. I then attach a Velcro clue strap by passing it through the clue eye until the metal eyelet is looping under the boom and then attaching back onto itself. At this moment, it is a good idea to ensure the main sheet will run clear and not be wrapped round the tiller, as I am doing now. Finally, attach the tack strap to the tack eye and loop it round the front of the mast. Before going afloat, don't forget to attach the jib sheets and dangly pole control to the jib clue. We use a bowline for the jib sheet in blue and a bowline at the knot for the dangly pole control. This is the red rope.
I'm sailing away, away, you're welcome. Cause now we can do everything but float. You're welcome, you're welcome, you're welcome. And thank you.